ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. I'm Tara Cactus.
Johnson Nash is my name. Husband to Ruby Nash. Lived in Prim going on 8 years now, thick and thin. I'm a trader primarily, for what it's worth with things like they are. I also run the local Mojave Express outpost.
Well, I don't got any work right now, sorry to say. I'll tell you whatever I can. You have a delivery order you can show me? Oh, you're talking about one of them packages. That job had strange written all over, but we couldn't turn down the cats. Well, now that you mentioned it, a few nights back, one of the townies was out scavenging for supplies. He said he saw a fellow with a daisy suit come through with some of them great con misfits. They was talking about a chip. Well, for that, your best bet is going to be talking to Deputy Beagle. Since they came to town, he was keeping a good bit of notes on them, and he was slinking around Bison Steve when your pretty boy friend came through. He may have heard where they were going. That cowboy robot had us hire 6 couriers. Each was carrying something a little different. A pair of dice, chess piece, that kind of stuff. Last word I have from the office, it looked like payment had been received for the other 5 jobs. Guess it was just your chip that didn't make it. First deadbeat we hired to do the job canceled. Hope a storm from the divide skins him alive. Well, that's where you came in. Yeah, got this look when he saw you next down on the courier list. His expression turned right around. Asked me if your name was for real. I said, sure as lack of rain, you were still kicking. Then he turned down the job, just like that. I asked if he was sure it was good money. No, let Courier 6 carry the package. That's what he said. Like the Mojave'd sort you out or something. Then he just up and walked out. No idea. Sounds like you two had a history for him to act like that. And turn down the money, too. Hope he didn't see any trouble in that package of yours. Maybe he thought your name was bad luck. Enough for me to say. Nope. Different fella. Bigger. Had himself a face on a screen. And he talked more like you or me. So be sure it's true. Hey, youngster. When you say I love you. Right now, Beagle is the closest Prim's got to any organized law. But he's still stuck up in Bison Steve. First thing I'd say is get his sorry butt out of there.
That be...
A courier dropped it off a couple of months back. I got it working for a little while, but the darn thing pooped out. I haven't been able to get it up and running again. I was hoping to use it for some courier work. That ain't gonna happen.
Hell if I know.
I don't think it's serious, but my tinkering days are long gone.
Are you welcome to try? It's yours if you can get it working. If I had my way, I'd dump it in the scrapyard in Novak and be done with the damn thing. Would have been a disaster
because of the age of the train and the scarcity of the replacement parts. In addition, word out of Camp Golf is that many NCR Rangers can expect redeployment in the near future. One anonymous soldier said it was part of a new strategy. Boy, the Mojave Wasteland is just a fascinating place, isn't it? You never know what's going to happen next. Ladies and gentlemen, this next song goes out from me to you.
Kapow, you dead, son. You darn beetrootin'. You ain't going to be living past that now. I'm too stupid to do it.
Who's there? There.
Your worst nightmare. Got him. care of the elevator. Damn it. You're dead soon. I'm gonna get you. Well, maybe not. Oh, we got a flamer. Fuck. Ah, that hurts. I gotta take you out real fast and real soon. Oh, thank God. Just keel over. We'll all be over soon. Some stuff. Wait a minute. Gotta get that reparo as well. Look pretty good. Oh, aren't you just a bucket of sunshine? Get out of here. I said go. Get. I'm gonna talk to you like you're a stray cat. Get out of here. Die for that.
I don't suppose you came here to rescue me. I'd cross my fingers, but my hands.
Why, yes, I am. It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm in a bit of a. My good lady, if you would just untie my. Oh, that's just marvelous. I think I'll be making my way outside now. The air is a little close. Oh, that's so gracious of you to offer to bodyguard me like that. But I'd only slow you down. See you outside.
Why aren't you just a puss-ass? Pussy. That didn't do anything. Play the guitar. Play it again. My Johnny. Okay, it's time to take that elevator and kill the rest of these guys up here. Maybe you're cold, but you're so warm inside. Johnny, had to go and hit me in the damn head. Now my cognitive functions are all messed up. What if you stay? I love you. What if you're cruel? You can be kind. I know.
Maybe I'm just jumping.
Found you. Bullet to the heart.
Like that?
And you're too low because you give him a bad name. Ah, fuck. Take that.
Got you now.
Do you? Do you have me now? I don't think so. But you will soon enough. Have enough. You're not getting away. I know my items is dangerously low. So items in this game, when they get dangerously low, they have a chance of, you know, breaking. Also, for some reason, his leg just kind of blew off his body. It's a little weird, if you ask me. Not gonna lie, it's a little sus, if you ask me.
Golf is that many NCR Rangers can expect redeployment in the near future.
Ooh.
One anonymous soldier said it was part of a new strategy. Moving on. Tensions are brewing in Freeside between the ruling gang known as the Kings and the large number of NCR squatters seeking refuge there. The leader of the Kings, who would only identify himself as the King, voiced his displeasure calling NCR citizens squad the devil in disguise. He added he didn't want to see the NCR in the ghetto and called for a mass quote return to sender. The news has been brought to you by the Vicky and Vance Casino.
He sounds just
Vicky
like a
Vance,
really good upstanding citizen.
More classics coming right up for you, so stay tuned.
Force such as you meets an old immovable object like me. You can bet just as sure as you
drugs.
Something's gotta give.
There we go. Oh, why doesn't look too nice? But you died in your bathtub from... Okay, so like, I just want to go over like the logic here, for example. So the bombs went off, and everyone got fried by all the radiation and shit. But like, how did you get fried inside? Like, the heat of the blast, sure, that's something, but like, you're telling me there were so many bombs dropped that he got fried completely, even inside in his bathtub, inside the water. Even though water has like a really low boiling temperature, maybe I'm just overthinking this, but holy shit, that's like a lot. It's a lot of bombs, man. A lot of things go boom.
But how long can anyone try?
It's a lot of big boom sticks. You know what I mean? Can I repair anything else?
We'll find out as sure as we live. Something's gotta give, something's
Oh, baby.
Something's gotta give.
Okay. I gotta sell some shit real soon. Well, let's get out of here. I saved the deputy.
Hey there.
Hey, youngster. Still hanging about Prim, huh?
Well, that was quite an adventure. We taught those convicts a thing or two. Breaking myself out of a hostage situation. Not to diminish your role in it, of course, but it was quite thrilling.
You're such an ass.
Problem is, there's still no law in Prim. What are we to do the next time ruffians menace us and hold us hostage? Ah, yes. My memory is much clearer now that I'm free from my bondage. I was performing recon, gathering information on some of the powder gangers, when some great cons arrived with your friend in the suit. They were talking about some delivery they took from a courier. I assume that was you. They said they'd be heading through Nipton to Novak to meet a contact there. Hello again. I don't suppose you... Oh, it should be someone brave like you, but more of a... I heard the sheriff that was in. You also may be able to convince.
Howdy, partner. What? Ah, shuck.
Oh, well. Well, time to head on over to this NCR guy over here. See what I can accomplish for him. Tumbleweeds are pretty scarce around here. Hey buddy, how you doing? Hope you have a fantastic day or not. That your life goes pretty well. Come on, bud, let's go. No, don't go down there. Oh, you left me. Why'd you leave me? Billy Bob, Tumbleweed, why'd you leave?
Got business here? Yeah. We know Prim is a great strategic point, and we aren't blind to the needs of the town, but we're barely holding our own against the powder gangers. We don't have the guns or the personnel needed to carry out our mission, much less take on... What we need more than anything is bodies. If we had just one more squad, we could easily install a sheriff and still handle our primary objective of protecting the interstate south of here. If you'd like to see the NCR include protection of Prim and its duties, then you'll have to get some more troops up here. Knight at Mojave Outpost may be able to help. Have you got...
...difficulties with its monorail line to the New Vegas Strip proved easy to fix. One anonymous official told us a serious mechanical failure would have been a disaster because of the age of the train and the scarcity of the replacement parts. Well, that's all I have for you. This is Mr. New Vegas wishing you ladylike luck tonight. Got a song for you now. It's about a guy who's cold on the exterior, but deep down, you know.
You know, let's go to the Mojave Outpost.
And his name is Johnny Guitar.
I think they'll be a whole lot better military-wise than trying to convince some powder ganger dipshit.
play it again, my Johnny. Maybe you're cold, but you're so warm inside.
So, something that I really like about Fallout New Vegas is it has this sort of like depressing atmosphere, yet also interesting, where it's so beautiful, yet it's also depressing at the same time, because you see a barren wasteland combined with a music choice. It can be really great and upbeat and skippy, but in the same regard be very oppressive, like it's a wasteland. And it feels very realistic to me. I don't know. Johnny Guitar. Buddy, I see you're bad, so you're gonna die. Wait, why am I naked?
What if you're cruel? Murderer! You can be kind. I know.
Oh, you wanna go, Buster? That's fine by me. I'll just miss every shot, but then kill you with one, and you'll explode into a million pieces. Because this makes sense. Don't question it. Fuck you. Oh, that's just really rude. Down on the front door. No. Jackal gang member. I don't like jackals. I'm more of a O'Hare kind of guy. Why is there a ghoul in here? Where did you come from? It's a bug. It's a stick bug. Now he's dead. You can't make your meme on me, Buster. Your memes don't work on me. Maybe they do, but they're not super hilarious to me.
Johnny Guitar. Play it again. Johnny Guitar.
This is Radio New Vegas, and I'm your host, Mr. New Vegas. And in case you're wondering if you've come to the right place, you have. This just in. Scavengers report hulking individuals moving around Hidden Valley after dusk, but have been unable to identify them due to low visibility. In addition, the Black Mountain radio signal is back after a long absence. Listeners say the new programming is, quote, less for outcasts, more for weirdos. You know, I think all news, whether it's good or bad, brings us closer together. Don't you? And now, I'd like to play one of my very favorite songs for you.
You're gonna die in there. Kapow. You stick bugs are no match for me. And my high-powered rounds of gunshots. Well, we're on our way out of here. Time to make our way over to, Oh, what the fuck are you doing there? How about no? And a double no to you. what can I drop? Wait, am I still over encumbered? No. But I do need some aid. That should help out mighty fine. The fuck is this thing over here? That's an ant. Just kind of slick on through here. Any stories I think that I can share about New Vegas? Oh, what's this say over here? Dead. The center cannot hold. Dead. Okay. I mean, death is a very temporary thing if you think about it. Depending on what kind of religion you are. If you're a Christian, well, death is only temporary. I guess in the grand scheme of things. Maybe. Hope it is. Hope it's just not an existential crisis of bunch, which there's nothing to ever live for. When I die, then I'll just be gone from this earth completely to a point where I won't be able to ever see anyone ever again. And why are there so many empty Nuka bottles? This is all the other thing that goes to my head. Death or Nuka bottles? I don't know. Coca-Cola or death? Choose one, but not the other. Bum ba da ba da. I actually have the song on record. It's next to me on a vinyl. Maybe I'll play it sometime if there's enough comments saying they want to see it. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Terracactus, and I'll see you in the next video. Ta-ta!